We can also add a fair bit of context to our analysis. We already discussed adding descriptions when we save our favorites. If we click on the triple arrows on the right-hand side, we can see these descriptions. We can also write interpretations about the individual items that we create. By writing these interpretations, we can have a discussion about the data that we are analyzing. We can see an example of an interpretation that's been written for this particular output. Note that we can also share these outputs with users. Here, if we click on the Edit button next to Sharing, we can decide which user groups can actually see this output. There are a couple different options here. If this is publicly available, this means that anyone in the system can actually view this particular favorite. You can see I can also give options to view and edit and view. If someone can view the object, that means they can only look at the object itself. So for example, they can pull up this particular chart and look at the data that's contained within it. But they cannot overwrite this chart with new inputs. If someone can edit and view, then they can actually take this favorite, modify some of the data dimension selections, and then overwrite the favorite. We can also select specific users to see this chart. We do this by searching for user groups and modifying their permissions. For example, if I want to share some details with the MCH program, I can find the MCH group. I will then add them. We can then modify their details. They can either view the chart, or they can edit and view the chart. We can add in multiple groups. And give them a variety of different sharing settings. This will determine which analyses users see in the system. We will go through an example where we show the effect this actually has in practice later on as well. You can see now, once I've updated the sharing settings, the user groups appear within this sharing description.